And the whole place is surreal. You've got massive Merry Christmas Santa Claus signs, got blokes with machine guns, and some really bad renditions of Christmas carols.
Although only 10% of Bethlehem's population are Christian, everyone here seems to be in the festive spirit.
And scouts have just turned up wearing a combination of Palestinian kefir and Santa hat.
The Palestinian military are out in force, and the Palestinian president is here, paying his respects at the Holy Church of the Nativity, below which is a cave at the very heart of Christianity.
Some real emotion as well, you know, there's lots of people crying and tears. Some real devotion. I don't really consider myself particularly religious, but to come to Bethlehem and go into, you know, the grotto of the Church of the Nativity for midnight mass on Christmas is something very special. But yeah, it's Christmas Day, so Merry Christmas.
I'm at the infamous barrier, a massive grey concrete wall that separates Israel from the West Bank.
So we go to Jerusalem, crossing the checkpoint, Bethlehem checkpoint. They call it checkpoint 300.
And I'm with a Palestinian Christian called Fadi, who is escorting me.
You've got a permit to go to Jerusalem, so you can travel there.
Yes, because it's Christmas time now.
Yeah.
And I'm Christian.
Yeah.
So they give Christians to go to Jerusalem for a specific time, like only for Christmas. And then after Christmas, I have no permit. I'm not allowed to go anymore.
Israel began building the separation wall in 2002 in response to a Palestinian uprising known as the Second Intifada, justified by the Israeli state as an anti-terror measure. It has huge implications on everyday life for Palestinians.
You grew up before the wall was built.
Yes.
I mean, what's it like being growing up in the shadow of this thing?
Like, when you see it like this, it's like living in a big prison. It needs only a roof, and then it will be a real prison. They say every time, if you ask them why you built this wall, they say, we want to secure ourselves from Palestinians. We are not terrorists, we are humans. You're stuck here. You can't go anywhere at all. Only in your city.
You want the freedom?
Of course, we go for freedom. Many Palestinians are against making graffiti on the wall.
Why is that?
Because they believe that in making graffiti on the wall, you beautify the wall.
There's nothing beautiful about that.
It's less than a six-mile walk to Jerusalem. But first, we must pass through Israeli border security.
Now we can't film anymore.
So yeah, just got through the security checkpoint between Bethlehem and Jerusalem. I mean, that was a real border, you know, that was like going through airport security, scanners, turnstiles, the full works, cameras everywhere, unless you've got all your papers and special permits to cross, you're just not allowed out. And it really does feel like you're living in a prison. So you can see from here, that's Bethlehem over there, where I've just come from. And then you've got this sort of no man's land here, and then a very obvious stark difference where the settlers have moved in, taken over this hill. So it feels like a fortress on top of a mountain. But the weird thing is, it's not, you know, I guess in people's imagination, the wall is one single wall around the West Bank, and that's not what it is at all, actually. It's, you know, you've got these settler communities or Jewish villages, depending on which side of the coin you look at it from. You know, and then there's these fragments of wall that just block off and divide communities.
The UN considers the building of all Jewish settlements in the West Bank illegal, a claim Israel disputes. But as I leave the West Bank, I reach the place at the heart of the controversy. Jerusalem, held sacred by Christianity, Islam, and Judaism, where the three religions coexist in less than half a square mile. Within these ancient walls, there's a mixture of conflict and cooperation.
It's a mosaic of cultures and beliefs, the Jerusalem.
So this is it.
At the site of the Church of the Holy Sepulchre, where Jesus is believed to have been crucified, the custodian of the front door key is a Muslim.
My family started from 7th century.
So your family has been in charge of the keys for 1,300 years. Why was a Muslim given the key?
To be neutral between the Christians.
The Al-Aqsa Mosque, the third holiest site in Islam, is policed by Israeli soldiers, much to the annoyance of many Muslims.
The Israeli soldiers there, what are they meant to be here for?
Protecting the settlers when they are attacking the mosque. They came here every day.
And what do they do?
Just to make the people angry. Mm. It's kind of provocation.
And just meters away, at the Western Wall, Jews pray at the site of their holy temple, destroyed by the Romans nearly 2,000 years ago, and on which now stands the Dome of the Rock.
If you want a temple to be rebuilt here, would that not involve removing the mosque?
We are not going to destroy or bomb or do anything to the mosque. Let God take care of it. It's his own home. Let him remodel it any way he wants.
The Israeli Defense Force, or IDF, are present on almost every corner in Jerusalem. And with national service compulsory for all Israeli citizens, defense of the state is a huge part of their national identity.